This is what my actual voice sounds like.
And this is what my voice sounds like using the magic of AI.
I was able to transform my voice into an AI voice thanks to the help of a voice actor and some real-time processing on my PC. We're going to look at how you can change your voice too. And best of all, it's completely free. Let's check out how. First off, head to the following website. You could click on the card up above or the link down below in the description. Once you land on the website, click on the text that says download Voicemod for free and then run through the installation process. Once you finish the installation, you'll land in an interface that looks like this. Before we start playing with some of these voices, over on the left-hand side, let's click on settings. Right here, you can choose what your microphone is that you would like to use. Select your microphone, and then down below, you can choose your output or the speakers that you want to hear the changed voice through. Once you finish making all of your selections, in the top left-hand corner, click back on Voice Box. On the Voice Box screen, here at the top, you see all of the different voices that you get for free with Voicemod. If you want additional voices, if you scroll down below, here you can see all the different premium voices that are available. But you get quite a few voices just with free, so that's what I'm going to use today. To use one of these voices, you simply click on it, and now this voice is active. If you want to preview what the voice sounds like, down in the bottom left-hand corner, here I could toggle on this button.
And now I can hear myself using this voice. Over here, you can also turn the voice changing on or off. Currently it's turned
on, but here I could turn it off and now I hear my normal voice.
Well, I'll turn this back on.
Here I could toggle off here myself. This is really good for just previewing these different voices. Over on the right hand side, I can also turn background effects on or off. And some of these voices come with background effects that you could use. With one of these voices selected, over on the right hand side, I see all of these different attributes that I can modify for this voice. One that's really interesting, you can also choose the specific character, or this is the voice actor that they used to train this AI model. I'll stick with the default of narrator. Now that you know how to change your voice, how do you actually use it in, say, an app like Discord, or on a phone call? Or maybe you just want to record your voice. Let's start by looking at how you could use it in an app. Here I am in Discord, and to use the Voicemod changed voice, down below, let's click on User Settings. And within User Settings, over on the left-hand side, click on Voice and Video. And right up at the top, you can choose your input device. This is the microphone that you would like to use in Discord. When you click on this dropdown, here you'll see an option for Microphone Voicemod Virtual Audio Device. Make sure to select that one. This will ensure that you are using the changed voice within Discord. And for the output device, or basically your speakers, you could set it to whatever you want. Now that we've selected that, you'll want to make a few adjustments within user settings to make sure the voice sounds as good as possible. There's one option for input sensitivity. Let's make sure to toggle that off. Voicemod already adjusts the sensitivity, so we don't need Discord doing that. If we scroll down just a little bit more, we'll find some more settings like noise suppression. Turn that off. Voicemod also offers that functionality. And if we scroll down a little bit more, there's echo cancellation. Toggle that off. Toggle off noise cancellation. And then also toggle off automatic gain control. And that's all you have to modify. Now when you join a voice chat or when you make a call through Discord, your new changed voice will be used. To change the voice that you use in Discord, within Voicemod, you could simply click on another voice.
Here, I'll click on Alice, and that voice is now being piped through to Discord.
To switch to another voice even more quickly, over on the right-hand side, under the attributes, you can add a key binding, or basically a shortcut key. When I click on that, let's say I want to assign the F7 key. I'll press F7, and now when I press that key, that will now activate this voice. And you can go through and assign different key bindings or shortcut keys to any one of these voices within Voicemod. To turn off the voice changer, within Voicemod here, I can click on the clean voice. Alternatively, I could also turn off the voice changing down below. Back within Discord, another way to turn off the voice changing is once again within your voice settings under input device, you can switch to one of your other microphones. Next, we're going to look at how you can change your voice on a phone call. And you can use apps like Google Voice or Skype to pull this off. Let's look at how you can do this in Google Voice. Here on Google Voice, to change my voice on a phone call, in the top right-hand corner, let's click on Audio Settings. And right at the top, just like we did within Discord, I can select my microphone. When I click on this dropdown, here too, let's select the one for Voicemod. Then click away, and now you can make a call and it'll use your changed voice. Lastly, we're going to look at how you can record your changed voice. And to do that, I recommend downloading an app called Audacity. You can click on the card up above or the link down below in the description. Once you install Audacity to record your changed voice, over by the input, click on this drop-down list, and just like we've been doing in Google Voice and also Discord, make sure to choose Voicemod as the input. Then over on the right-hand side, you can choose whatever speaker you want. To record, press on the red record icon, and I am now recording my changed voice directly within Audacity. Once you're done recording, click on the stop icon, and then you can click to play it back.
Record icon, and I am now recording my changed voice.
Audacity is by far one of my favorite ways to both record and then also edit audio. If you would like a full walkthrough of how to use Audacity, check out the video up above. All right, well, hopefully you now know how to change your voice and you can have some fun with it. To watch more videos like this one, please consider subscribing, and I will see you in the next video.